Hello students, today's class is for class 8 and our topic is physical and chemical change. In previous two classes I have explained that what is change and different types of changes and their examples. In today's class I have discussed another type of change and some physical and chemical changes. Okay, so let's start the class. So the first point is types of changes. Okay, types of changes, and I have explained three types of changes, that is slow change, fast change, man-made change, natural change, and periodic change, non-periodic change. So another type of change, that is fourth type of change is reversible change and irreversible change. Okay, reversible change and irreversible change. Reversible change means changes that can be reversed back to its original change are reversible changes, and irreversible changes are those that cannot be brought back to its original change. After the change has occurred, the change state cannot be brought back to the original state, that is irreversible, and those changes that can be brought back or can be reversed back to its original state are reversible changes. So what can we say? For reversible change we can say changes that can be reversed. Changes that can be reversed to its original state. Changes that can be reversed to its original state are reversible changes. So I first discuss some examples of reversible changes. So the simplest example is ice is melting to the water and water is going in the form of ice. So how can we convert water into ice? That is, we are freezing it. We are lowering the temperature, and ice melts when it comes to the normal room temperature. That is, when the temperature is increased, ice cube is going to the water form. Okay, so that conversion, that is water is going to ice form and ice is converting to water. But this conversion cannot be occur until when the temperature is altered. That is, in the definition state, you should mention one point, that is changes that can be reversed to its original state when conditions are altered. Okay, so you should mention here when some conditions are altered. Okay, when some conditions are altered. So here, what is the condition? Here the condition is temperature. When we are increasing the temperature, ice is converting into water. And when we are decreasing the temperature, water is converting to the ice. So when we are altering some conditions, that is temperature, pressure or anything else, in that case some changes are reversing back to its original state. Okay, and that changes are reversible changes. So this is the simplest example of reversible change. Okay, now what will be the irreversible change? So changes, for irreversible change we can write changes that cannot be brought back. Changes that cannot be brought back to its original state by any means, okay, to its original state by any means. Suppose we are breaking a glass, the glass is broken, okay, and we cannot regain the glass from the glass pieces, okay. So what will be the example? Breaking of a glass. We cannot regain the old form of glass from the glass pieces that is formed after breaking of the glass. Okay. What will be the second example? We are tearing a piece of paper. The piece of paper converts into small piece of papers, and we cannot convert this small piece of papers to its original state. The total piece of paper, that is the large piece of paper, cannot be gained from that small piece of papers. Okay, so tearing of a paper into small pieces. Okay, from these pieces, that paper cannot be regained. Okay, and the third example will be cooking of food. Okay, I have explained earlier that cooking of food is a man-made change, and after cooking, the what we are getting after cooking, it cannot be changed back or brought back to its original state. Okay, so if I am telling that what name a man-made change, that is also an irreversible change. So I am writing that name a man-made change, name a man-made change that is an irreversible change, that is an irreversible change. So we can write here the answer is cooking of food. Cooking of food, the change cannot occur without human beings, and after cooking, the food has changed it from the vegetables or fruits, everything else, the vegetables has changed its form after cooking, and it cannot be reversed back to its original state. So this is the answer. Now in the types of changes, there are another two types, that is physical change and chemical change. The two types are, one is physical change and second is chemical change. Okay, one is physical change and second is chemical change. So if I am discussing about physical change, it will be, what is physical change? So human beings are growing up, there is some change in their appearance, like looks, height, figure, everything, and that is the physical change. So physical change means the changes, temporary changes in some physical properties, like its odor, state, shape, everything. Okay, so we can write physical change, it is a change in physical properties, and obviously it is a temporary change. Okay, physical change is a temporary change in physical properties, like state, shape, okay, smell, size, etc. So state means solid state going to liquid state going to vapor state, that is the change of state, and it is a physical change. Change in shape, smell, size, etc., all these are physical changes. So at first we'll discuss some properties of physical change. Okay, properties of physical change. some properties of physical change. The first characteristics is no new substances are formed. No new substances are formed. What does that mean? That means, suppose again take the water example, that is water in the liquid state is going to the solid state, or you can write it ice. Okay. See here, when water is converting to the ice, the composition of water, that is H2O, the composition of water is H2O, and it remains same when it is converting to ice. That is, if we are writing the composition of ice, the composition of ice is also H2O. So see here, what has changed? Water means it liquid, it is liquid, and ice means it is solid. So the state, actually the state has been changed, but the chemical composition, that is H2O, has not been changed. Water is also H2O and ice is also H2O. So that's why no new substances are formed. That is, only the state is changing and composition, chemical composition remains the same. So it is not forming any new substances. It is just converting into its another form. Water is converting into its another form in ice. Okay. So this is one characteristics. There, no new substances are formed when water is converting to ice its chemical composition. Its chemical composition remains same. Okay, its chemical composition remains same. That means chemical composition no new substances has formed. Okay, so in today's class I have explained one properties of physical change. In next class I'll discuss some more properties of physical change and chemical changes. Okay.